Welcome back to York Stadium on the York University campus in North York, Ontario. Dominic Badula here alongside Alex Kuhn calling this game between the York Lions and the Western Mustangs, second of an OUA doubleheader live on SSN Canada. First place on the line here today in the OUA West Division. York's going to start with the ball. So we look forward to a quality up-tempo matchup with Alex a lot on the line.
Oh, for sure. Definitely a lot. Teams separated just by 2 points for the top of their division, I guess, top of the Western Conference and top of the league. So it's really a battle for first place here today.
That'll be Mrochik and, sorry, that would be Pena kicking the ball off with Alberti at center field. As the Lions look to get off to a quick start here in this one. York wearing their red home jerseys, while the Mustangs are dressed in all white. And here we are underway at York Stadium. First place on the line, ball controlled quickly by Antonini. Smith switches it over across the field. And the Lions are to the attack early. Lions with some good pace to this offense. They're going to look to put Western under pressure immediately. The only chance they have to jump them in the standings is with maximum points here today, which would require a victory. Western with 33 points in the standings. York with only 31. As the top two teams in the OUA West battle for supremacy. Lions on the attack here early. Good challenge there in the middle. As LeMay with a shot. That's blocked up straight in the air. And the men will look to turn it around.
Western here, playing with the wind at their back early. Saw last game, York used that wind to their advantage in the second half, and they'll have it in their second half again.
Good step over there on the right side is Bedard, getting into the 18-yard box. He drops that back to the top of the 18-yard box for Pena. He dishes it back. Western with a good job stopping the attack there, and here come the Mustangs. Looking to move the ball in transition. That's Mrochik. Got a little too far ahead of the ball there. And York will win it back. Number 5, Smith with the ball on the back end. He gives that ball over to Nogueira. Nogueira dishing it off. York moving forward as a team. Here go the Lions over midfield and into the attacking zone. Lions on the attack once again. Beautiful inside out move. Centering pass to Lamy. Lamy heads that down, ball bouncing around. Wind obviously a little bit of a factor here as Pena with the steal. Pena dishing it off to Lamy. That ball bounce loses one again, and the Mustangs will clear it. That's Zoger with the clearance.
York getting it going early on in this game, bringing it down in on net. So far they've got all the pressure in this on this undefeated Western team.
And they did an excellent job there of winning the early corner. Lions know. In order to stop that heavy Mustangs attack, they're going to have to put the pressure on. Sometimes the best defense is a good offense, and the Lions have earned an early corner kick here at the 3-minute mark. Short corner played in, top of the 18-yard box. Ball crossed in, and a one-time shot there. A little bit of a tough first touch there by Mestorovic. He was wide open near the penalty kick spot, but places it high over the bar. First real quality chance for either team here in this game. Lions come up short.
Yeah, ball just managed to find its way into him, bounced around, and he had the wide open shot, but just sailed it high.
Feeling the pressure a little bit inside the 18-yard area. Didn't get over the ball, and Mestorovic sails it high over the crossbar. Keeps the score 0-0. And a big goal kick from Murdoch. Header down by Smith at midfield. Here come the Lions again. Back inside the 18-yard box. The quick shot sails high, though. That looked like Alberti with the shot, number 6. And it'll be another Western goal kick.
Alberti's definitely a dangerous player. One of the leaders up front. 6 goals in the season. He's having a fantastic year.
Big kick coming up for Murdoch. Sends it past midfield. And the Lions get the ball loose here. Handball will give the free kick to the Mustangs. And the quick play off. Ball's bouncing around at midfield. And knocked away quickly by Walton. So just over 5 minutes here into this game. Lions dominating the possession so far. Western without real chance so far. They're going to change that here as the Mustangs get off to the rush. But Lammy's going to win that ball back for the Lions. And here comes York on the counterattack. Bit of a tough ball played there by Penna. Too far ahead of the right flanker. And it's out of bounds for a Mustangs throw. Ball played out of bounds for the throw-in. Got over the back a little bit of the York defender there, and the Lions are going to be awarded with a free kick. All 4 Lions defenders lining up at midfield as they look to move the ball forward. Here's number 4, Antonini on the left side. He plays that for it, but it's knocked right back, and Antonini's fighting for it at midfield. Ball gets deflected back over midfield and into the Lions' zone, where Fabrizi recovers it for the Lions. Fabrizi giving and going, pushing it forward. Probably would like to have that touch back after giving it away at midfield, but the Lions have the ball. Great push forward here on the right flank. It's Penna again. Back into the 18-yard box. A little bit of a chip on goal. Murdoch's going to have no trouble controlling that one for the Mustangs. However, that ends that threat.
Murdoch getting some action early here. One of the best goaltenders this league. 11 shutouts this season for the undefeated goaltender.
Smith plays that ball over to the middle for Fabrizi once again, who brings it to midfield and dishes it off to the right flank. Ball's controlled there by number 11, Mastarovich. Knocked out of bounds by the Mustangs defender, and it's going to be a York throw-in. That ball goes right back to the Mustangs. Mastarovich back, battling hard for it. He wins that throw-in, and the Lions are quickly to the attack again. Switching the side of the field, Antonini is going to have to hustle back to get that ball. Wynn might have carried it a little further back than he had anticipated, but either way, here comes Antonini off the left side. Dishes it off to Smith. Smith playing it back to that right side. Lions looking to attack using that right flank. Referee's going to blow the ball dead here and award the Mustangs with a free kick.
Much like the first game, both teams just kind of feeling each other out, getting a feel for the game. But it's been mostly all York. Western's really had no chance to move the ball in, but the defense is still limiting the York chances.
big kick into the 18-yard box, knocked away, and cleared out by the Lions. Sent back forward. And the referee's going to call that one dead with the offside. You are trying to move the ball quickly. Neither team really able to maintain possession here in the early going as we reach the 9-minute mark of the first half. Obviously a lot on the line here in this game, and both teams looking to get settled in here at York Stadium. That's number 20 for Breezy, battling for the ball and doing an excellent job of getting it out of his own 18-yard box. Taken away, though, however, by number 2, Morrissey, and he sends that one into the York penalty area. Tough header there. Mustangs with a great chance, and no mistake made there. A little bit of a tough header. The York defender gives the ball away, and just like that, the Mustangs have the early 1-0 lead.
And what a shot from well outside. Absolute perfect placement of the ball. First mistake made by the Lions, and Western capitalizes.
So in the 10th minute of the game, it's Western's number 7, Vince Caminiti, the defenseman, pushing up. A little bit of a tough touch for the Lions defender there. It gives the ball away, and a quick setup for Caminiti to put it in the top right shelf, getting a 1-0 lead for Western. So a lot like the first game with the women's that we saw earlier on in the day, with York providing most of the early pressure, but Western getting that one break. That's all they needed to pull ahead 1-0 here. We know this Mustangs team is dangerous. They're undefeated this season with 33 points, ranked 3rd overall in the country, and showing why there with Caminiti depositing that one top shelf. Western awarded the free kick here as they push forward, looking to put the pressure on the Lions after establishing the early 1-goal lead. Caminiti with the kick. You see the wind factoring into the game again there as that ball sailed high over the bar and out of bounds. That's going to be a goal kick awarded to the Lions. Big kick there by the Lions goaltender. Ball played away there and brought back by Western. Here come the Mustangs on the attack. A little too much there on that touch, though. Ball sails wide and out of bounds. It's going to go all the way to the York end for a goal kick.
You can see early that goal really just sparked the Mustangs offense. It appeared to be all Lions to begin the game, but again, one fluke and the one nice shot, and Western's bringing it back to him.
It'll be Varlakosis with the goal kick. Antonini pushing up. The Lions look to get back in shape here, trailing early in the first half, 1-0. Goal by Mustangs defender Vince Caminiti, a difference so far in this one. And both teams look to have settled down here after some tough back and forth play in the early going. Penna with the turn and the flick forward to LaFlamme. LaFlamme on the right side. Unable to get much going there as Mustangs contend just to kick that ball back out of bounds and avoid any danger. Guerra plays that ball forward, bounces off the York the Mustangs defender and out of bounds. It'll be another Lions throw. Ball played in there. Once again, the Lions looking to get something going. Ball bouncing around. Here's Antonini just outside the 18-yard box. He's going to have a go at the goal. and just wide of the goal. Murdoch followed that one all the way to the post. Antonini not able to get enough on it with two defenders in his face, but a solid go at goal there.
Definitely had a great go, and he was like, forced that shot into the strong wind. Nearly found the net.
Lamy with the ball. He plays that one over to Penna. Ball cleared in, and once again sailing just past the goal. Mustangs keep that ball in bounds on the goal line and clearing it out. But linesman's flag is up, and that ball is going to be called out of bounds for a Western goal kick. Ball played all the way down the Western on the left flank. Here come the Mustangs. Another chance. Shot on goal. Didn't get much on that one there. Easy save for Varla Costas. Here's Zolger with a throw for the Mustangs. Lions get control of that ball right away. Looking to get something going. Ball played to Lamy on the right-hand side. Referee's going to blow that ball dead, call the foul against the Mustangs. You see Lamy started it over on the left side, but making the adjustment here after the first Mustangs goal as we reach the 16-minute mark. It's 1-0 Western. There's Lamy breaking down the right flank. Looking to find a way to get that ball into the 18-yard box. Does an excellent job of drawing the foul once again. And the Lions are going to have an excellent opportunity here with a free kick just to the right side of the 18-yard box. Everyone pushes forward here for York.
Excellent battle going down the right side. Those two are going at it. As they took the ball down, it ended up with the York free kick.
Lions with the chance at the free kick here. Mustangs content with the two-man wall. As Murdoch gets it set up on the left side. Everyone forward for the Lions. Smith with excellent position, but a little bit of a short kick, and Western's going to have no trouble clearing that out to center where the ball is met by Antonini. Antonini plays it right back in. And once more, here come the Lions. Chance to break through the middle here. That gap shut down really quickly. The Lions are going to have a tough time getting it into the 18-yard box. Penna dishes off to Lamy. Here's a chance for Lamy. He elects to dish it off, though. The Mustangs defender getting in the way, and that ball is going to be cleared. Out to midfield. Lions on the attack once again. Inside out, here's Penna breaking into the 18-yard box. That ball is going to be cleared away and out of bounds once again. It's going to be a Lions corner kick.
The Western's defense is doing a great job so far, containing the league's leader in goals. He's got 12 in the season, that's Penna. But he's still getting close. They need to keep this on if they're going to get the shutout here. But it's going to be tough. Two great offenses, and you can really tell they're getting their chances early.
So a Lions corner kick coming up. Dishing the ball in with the left foot. Ball centered into the middle. Excellent chance. Ball bouncing around, but the Lions unable to find it. And it's the blue jersey of Murdoch emerging to grab that ball and clear it out of danger.
The ball just bounces right into the goalie. It seemed no one could get a head on it there.
Mustangs looking to regroup and get back to the attack here. Approaching the 19-minute mark of the first half. Vince Caminiti, the only goal scorer in this one, the defender for Western, has the Mustangs out in front. Antonini with the ball. Switches the field, and here comes York once more. Pushing the ball forward through the center. That ball is going to bounce easily to Murdoch, and he'll control that without a problem. pocket kick from Andrew Murdoch. Western looking to get the ball at midfield. There's Caminiti again. Lions quick on that ball, knocking it out of bounds. It'll be a Western throw-in. Here comes another chance for Western. Ball at the top of the 18, lining up the shot from just outside the penalty box. That ball nowhere close to its target, however, and it'll be a Lions goal kick.
Both these teams are not afraid to shoot the ball. The two teams with the league's highest goal totals. The Lions have 41 and the Mustangs have 23. So it's quite amazing. 41 goals, nearly double what's the second ranked team has. So it's going to be an offensive battle here and lots of shots on target, so the keepers will be busy.
And Western showing why they lead the OUA in goals early with that Vince Caminiti strike, a defender making no mistake with the early opportunity, giving the first place team the early lead.
Western second, that is, Dom. It's the Lions with 41.
Ball played at midfield by the Red. Looking to push it forward. Western takes that ball over. Trying to get something to go on the counterattack, but it's Antonini back first for the Lions. Antonini with time to turn. Looks to play it forward. Takes a hard tackle there. Linesman's going to have his flag up. A late challenge there by Mavrikos. Referee having a couple of words with him there. Antonini will play it back to Smith at the top of the 18-yard box. He switches the field, and here come the Lions. Ball played up past midfield. There's a lovely inside-out play by Nogueira. Cheeky flick onto Lammy, back to Nogueira. Can't get that ball, and Lammy's going to be tough-pressed to get possession back here. Nogueira's got it, though. Lammy making sure he doesn't go offside. Now giving chase to that ball, but Western will be content to clear it out.
Talk about how this game could be an offensive battle, but the last time these two teams met, it was the Mustangs winning just one by one goal. 1-0 was the final, so it turned out to be a defensive struggle. But early on, it doesn't look like that'll be the case with a goal within the first 20 minutes.
Yeah, talking about that early goal by Vince Caminiti, not much in the way of pressure or quality opportunities for either side since then. As this battle is being played mostly at midfield, both teams are going to get something going here as we reach the 22-minute mark of the first half. Ball played around here and into the other end for Antonini. He plays it down the left flank. That's number 19, Badat. Badat getting it into the 18-yard box. Ball bounces around there before it's being played away by Vava. Smith steps up. The defender Smith looking to the right side. Lions trying to get something going here in the first half. Lammy centers the ball. The ball might have gotten out of bounds, though. The referee is going to call it out of bounds, and it will be Murdoch to take the goal kick for the Mustangs. So it's Bell playing it for the Mustangs. He's pressured by Badat. Plays it through the middle. Here come the Mustangs. Onto the attack. There's Mavrikos calling for the ball and a trip called there. Free kick's going to go to the Mustangs as they look to build on this early 1-0 lead.
Number seven. 7, Vince Gimini on the ball for the Mustangs.
See Caminiti here making some adjustments before the free kick. Another great opportunity for Western to build on their early lead. Ball played into the 6-yard box, bouncing high. And it looked there like Mrojek diving to connect with that ball. Can't get a hold of it early enough. And that'll bounce off the side of the goal and out of bounds for a York goal kick.
We saw in the first game with the women, York used the wind for the free kicks just around that location, generate lots of scoring chances, and Western almost took advantage of the same thing.
Mustangs with some good early chances here today. That ball's played out of bounds. And a throw-in's coming up for the York Lions. Ball played back and forth. It's Nestorovic fighting for that ball in the center. Everybody back for the Mustangs, though, and they'll do a good job of moving it out. And here comes a counterattack. Ball knocked away. Antonini's got time. He's going to be pressured once again by Mavrikos. There's Antonini. Looking in the middle to Bedat. And number 16, Noguera. York playing it all the way back and switching the field. Lions going to work that right side once again. 8 men pushing forward for York as they get to the 18-yard box. Some contact there. Referee keeps his whistle down. Ball centered into the middle. And the Mustangs will clear that ball before any shots on goal. Antonini plays that ball forward. Knocked all the way back in into Smith. Smith will control it. Once again, no surprise here. York will switch the field. They're really working that right side early on in this game. Play through the middle. There's number 10. It's Penna. He looks for number 19, Bedat. Ball moving around, and it's Antonini pushing forward. Lions looking to break this Mustangs defense. What a terrible pass there by Orlov. And here comes Western to the attack. It's Mavrikos. Mavrikos looking for Morchek. A little too much on that ball. That's going to bounce easy to Verlokostas.
You just got to be smarter with the play right there. Just one bad pass. You spring the Mustangs offense, and it's a very dangerous one at that. You can't be making those mistakes, especially in a game this important late in the year.
Ball played forward and knocked around midfield. It's Caminiti on the left side. Caminiti centering it to number 10. That's Mrojek. Mrojek trying to get in on goal, and that ball's knocked away. Mustarovic with the ball for the Lions. York trying to push forward here. Knocked wide and back down. Lions will move the ball to Smith. He looks on the left side to Antonini. Antonini with the ball. Trying to fit it through to Alberti. That's not going to work. Here come the Mustangs in transition. It's Mavrikos. In on goal, but well played there by the defender Fabrizi, knocking it back to his goaltender. And the Lions avoid a little bit of danger there.
Definitely. Mavrikos got sprung there. He was looking for his 11th goal of the year and came dangerously close.
He'll get another chance here as Mavrikos is breaking loose with Mrocek coming up on that right flank. Can't get it the first time. They'll try again. Mustangs with Bell breaking out on the right side. The defender, Bell, moving in. Tries to center it. Antonini doing a good job of blocking that ball. And it's out of bounds for a corner kick.
See right now, number 19, Bedat. He's sprawling effort to stop that cross. And he seems to be injured. Stays down a little longer. He's as he limps back into position there. He's going to be okay.
So the ball's knocked out of bounds for the corner kick.
Number seven, Vince
Giamanini. Western with the chance on the ball. Looking to extend this lead to two goals. Ball played on the ground, bouncing right through the 18-yard line dangerously. But the Lions get it out of their own penalty box and clear it out past midfield all the way down to Murdoch, who fumbles the ball a little bit there. The Lions with the chance there. The forward, that was, I believe, Badat. No, sorry, that was Penna. Tackled a little bit by Murdoch as he fumbled the ball in his own 18-yard box. That almost resulted in a Lions goal.
You really saw he was not happy with that. Botch play by Murdoch, and he was able to recover just in time. Otherwise, there would have been no one stopping Penna from grabbing his 13th of the year.
So a free kick being awarded to the Mustangs. Just under 15 minutes to go here in the first half. Vince Caminiti's goal, the only difference so far between the first and second place teams in the OUA West standings, as Western looks to build a little bit of separation between them and the Lions. Only 2 points separate these two teams in the standings this year. And it's Penna with a lovely turn, give and go. Working that ball around. And Alberti's going to go down. A free kick's going to be awarded to the Lions. Tough tackle there. He's a little bit shaken up on the play.
Clutching his ribs, it looks like. May have been a little contact in there that got him in a sore spot. Or is it the... Does he adjust his socks?
Seems to be capable of walking it off as the Lions will set up their free kick. Western goalie Andrew Murdoch looking to get his wall set up. This ball spot on. About 15 yards outside of the 18-yard box. And it's going to be Penna having a go at goal. Beautiful free kick by Penna. Just gets over the wall. But Murdoch had that one telegraphed. Didn't even have to move. And a chance for the Lions goes to waste here late in the first half. Here comes Western once again. Ball knocked out and carried away for Lamy again. So some chippy play here, not much in terms of possession for either team. Antonini is going to control as the Lions look to regroup. That ball's played by Orlov over to the right side. Fabrizi moving forward. That ball bounces into Lamy in the 18-yard box. A nice chance there, but unable to control it. York unable to get the shot on goal, but at least getting the corner kick here. As we reach the 33rd minute mark.
Excellent recovery there by the Western defender. He was initially beat, but able to boot that ball away on the out of bounds. It's again just limiting the York, limiting that York's high-powered offense, not allowing them to get their 42nd goal of the year.
There's a corner kick. Not much on that one as it bounces right out towards midfield. Orlov's going to meet that one and look to turn. Unable to do so there, however. And that ball's knocked away. Antonini moving forward on the left flank. Off the free kick. Here come the Lions once again. They're going to break forward, but that flag's going to be up. Linesman calling the offside. That spoils another opportunity for the Lions.
Yeah, just about 10 minutes to go. 11 or 12 minutes, 11 here, so... But the York's starting to get their chances. Western dominated most of the first half, but now York's turned this around as the second half winds down. First half winds down.
Dominic Bell getting some air there. He was right over top of the Lions player, and he's going to be whistled for a foul there. An athletic play. But with the Lions player already establishing position on the field, the referee's going to call that one for Bell getting over his back, and the Lions are going to get the ball. There's Antonini breaking forward over the left side. Lovely ball into the 18-yard box. Over on that right corner, here's Orlov. He's going to switch that over to the right flank. Lions trying to get something going, but a little bit too much there, and Caminiti's going to break away for the Mustangs. Ball played forward to the two strikers. There's Molchek. A little bit too much on that ball. Probably would like to have that touch back. Ball trickles in to the York goalkeeper, who plays it right back up to Antonini. Antonini drops that ball off and then gets it back. Lions trying to build something on this left side. Antonini to Bedat. Wide open, good first touch, dishes it off. And he gets it back. There's Bedat using his speed down the left side, breaking into the touchline. Beautiful ball into the middle, but that's played away and given away once again. A tough touch by the Western defender there, but York unable to capitalize, and that ball's cleared once again.
When Bedat took that ball down along the left, the Western keeper and defenders were all saying that went out of bounds. It looked over, and no flag. They were almost given a second opportunity because everyone was too busy complaining about it being out of bounds.
Antonini playing that ball forward. Good run here by number 16. Ball played to the middle. Nogueira with that chance breaking through. It's still bouncing around there at the top of the 18. York having a tough time settling it down, however. And here come the Mustangs. Lovely through ball there to Molchek. But Smith, he had a step on him there. Smith, no problem dropping that back to Varlo Kostas. We'll have a couple of looks before deciding to go to the right side. Fabrizi with the ball going back over to the left side. Antonini's got it. Antonini going forward on the left side. Over to Smith. He switches the field. York trying to get something going forward. Ball played out of bounds. Last touch by Caminiti, and it's going to be a Lions throw. That's Penno with the ball. Some fancy footwork there on the right flank. Ball cleared out by Western, however. And the Mustangs making sure everything stays to the outside. So here we are at York Stadium. Dominic Padula alongside Alex Kuhn for this OUA West matchup for first place. Lions currently trailing the Mustangs 1-0 as that ball moves all the way back into the York area. Western hanging back as Smith begins the attack for the Lions. Plays it to Antonini and Bedat. Bedat, lovely move to the middle. But a terrible giveaway. Beautiful first touch. Probably would have liked to have that second one back, however. So Lions having a tough time breaking the strong Mustangs defense core. Here comes the throw. Ball played back to Smith. Lions repeatedly trying to get something going here on offense. Mustangs content to hang back and protect their early one-goal lead here late in the first half. It's Bedat once again on the left flank. Two defenders on him. Dishes it back to Antonini. Ball played in and cleared away once again, and it's Molchek breaking away for the Mustangs. Ball cleared up back into the York area. Simple job done there by Misterovic to allow it to go out of bounds. So lovely job shielding it, and York will get it back. We see Smith dishing off to Antonini once again. Antonini looking to try something different here. He'll play it over to Orloff. Orloff makes the turn and dishes off to Fabrizi. He'll have a go at it from well out. That one's nowhere near the target. Not much of a threat for Murdoch. He'll watch that one sail out of bounds for a goal kick.
Once again, with just about 5 minutes remaining in the half here, York's taking their strikes with these long balls. They'll be better off serving those up in the second half when they have the wind at their back. As this continues, though, to be a more defensive struggle, only one goal. When coming into the game, the teams have had about 60 goals or so combined.
Ball bounces around at midfield there. Where the Lions get back to the attack. Ball played to Antonini on the left flank. Antonini pushing it forward to Lamy. Lamy with the ball. Doing an excellent job of keeping possession of it. Lamy looking for an opening here. He's got one. Plays it off to Orloff. Over on that right flank once again. Beautiful inside-out move. Lions try to center it. Lovely touch there by number 19, Aguera. Unfortunately, no one there except the white jerseys, and the Mustangs will clear once again.
Excellent job making something, though, of a player across that seemed to be well out of position for anyone to get a foot on. But that did that.
Lovely turn there by Mrocek, and he's still on the ball. Hard foul called against the Lions here, though. And as we reach the 42-minute mark of the first half, 1-0 Lions, or sorry, 1-0 Mustangs, the score. Western's going to have another opportunity with a free kick from just outside the 18-yard box.
That was the first caution of the game given to number 11, Franco Mastrovic of the Lions.
So a booking there, first booking of the contest. Yellow card to Mustangs.
Number 7, Vince Caminiti of the ball.
Vince Caminiti is going to take the free kick. Caminiti with the drive on goal, and once again, it's Vince Caminiti with an absolute howitzer from just outside the 18-yard box. Dead on goal. It looked like Varlikostas might have had a tough time projecting where that ball would go. And that's a simple case of Varlikostas slow to get off his line and an absolute bullet beating him on that right side. It's Caminiti's second of the game.
Oh, fantastic strike by Caminiti there. Finding its way through the crowd. Absolutely perfect shot. Making this game 2-0.
So 2-0 Western, couple of big blasts from Caminiti. Difference here in the first half, less than 2 minutes to go here before injury time. And despite solid play from the Lions, unable to penetrate that Mustangs defense, and Western with a couple of great opportunities showing how to capitalize. That's why they're the best in the OUA West.
And Mustang down here just in that little battle for the ball.
Appears as though it's Mrocek that's down at center field. A referee standing over him now. He's going to walk that one off. And it's going to be a throw-in for Western.
Just about 30 seconds to go here in this first half.
There's Lamy with the turn. Plays it to Penna. Lions trying to get something going before the end of the first half. They've been able to build out of their own end, but unable to capitalize so far, as we're in the 44-minute mark of this game. And so far, despite some excellent possession from the Lions and some good pressure, unable to penetrate that Mustangs defense, Western making them pay in transition. Ball's played in, full 45 minutes already played here at York Stadium. Western with the ball and a chance to extend their lead even further here. Play it in over the line and out of bounds behind the York goal. Barla Costas plays it to Antonini. And that's going to be all for the first half. So a couple of Vince Caminiti goals. The difference in this one, a Western Mustangs leading the York Lions 2-0. For Dominic Padula and Alex Kuhn, we're going to take a quick break. We'll see you for second half kickoff. Here we are back on SSNCanada.ca. Dominic Padula alongside Alex Kuhn looking to get second half action underway here at York Stadium. A lovely October afternoon. Western and York battling for first spot. Mustangs with the two-goal lead of a pair of Vince Caminiti goals in the first half. And after kickoff, looking to get right to the attack once again. Western dominating the OUA standings. They're ranked fourth in the country. Chance to gain some separation here with another 45 minutes of solid play.
York has the win this time, so he should definitely look to take advantage of that. Or sorry, York, yes. As they look to get some pressure early, but that's, you gotta pass better than, pass the ball better than that.
Ball played up on the left side, there's Antonini. He plays that ball forward and it's pulled away. Now to midfield where Mavrikos gets the ball. Taken away by number 20, that's Fabrizi. Fighting back and forth at midfield. Mavrikos with the chance. That's taken away again by Fabrizi. Solid job by the defender. As Orlov controls the ball for the Lions and moves it to the left flank. Here comes York, pushing on to the attack. There's Lamy. Lamy with the shot, stopped by Murdoch. Murdoch did not see that one coming until the last second. Fortunately for him, it was right on target, and he makes the save.
That's the second time this game that the ball's just kind of popped out for Lamy, and he's missed two opportunities like that. They've got to execute those, especially in the second half, being down 2-0 to a fantastic Western team.
Ball's played out and knocked away. Pushed over to the right flank to Fabrizi. Fabrizi over to Smith. He'll switch the field. Mustangs with all 11 men back. Looking to hold this two-goal lead. Another road win would all but cement their status as the top team in the OUA West. Ball pushed forward to number 10. That's Mrochik at center field. Knocked out of bounds easily there. It'll be a Mustangs throw.
Talk about Western going for the York, or for the road win here. They're perfect on the road. Well, not necessarily perfect. They have two ties, but four wins on the road. York at home, they are perfect. 5-0 is their record here.
Referee's flag up. Foul is going to be called against the Lions here. And there's going to be a free kick.
York getting settled defensively here. Controlling the ball. Pushing it upfield, not letting Western get any real solid pressure early.
So the Lions continue to move the ball around in their own end, looking for something. As they trail two goals, they're going to have a tough time getting back into this. And here they come again, Western on the left side. Looking to push it forward. There's Antonini. Ball bouncing up to midfield. Looks played forward to number 21, that's Hassan. Hassan loses a ball and it's number 10, Penna breaking away for the Lions. Penna with the ball, loses it at midfield. Both these teams fighting for possession. As they fight through the middle, not really opening up on the flanks. As you see Hassan there on the left side calling for the ball. Not sure why he hasn't gotten it. Either way, it's going to be a free kick.
Mavrikos thinking it should go his way that time. But Lions Lions bring it back, but give the ball up at midfield again.
Here's Penna. Sorry, that's number 10. Rochick breaking loose on the left side for Western on the attack again. The next goal will be crucial, as if Western can get it, it'll all by solidify the win. Nice little move there, but ball knocked away by York, and here they go with a counterattack. Lions desperate to get something going here in the second half. Nice chance here. Here's the follow-up shot. Scores! Number 6, Alberti with a beautiful blast with the left foot, and just like that, it's a one-goal game.
Ball pops out to Alberti, and he makes no mistake on this one. Pano carrying it upfield off the York defender, off the Western defender. Drops out to Alberti over the keeper for his 7th goal of the year.
So at the 50-minute mark, York taking a page out of the Mustangs book with the goal in transition. Doing a beautiful job and a beautiful finish by Alberti there. It's a one-goal game. Western back to the attack. Looking to answer after having their lead cut into half. Lions got the ball again, though, and here they go on the attack. It's Antonini pushing forward with pace. Antonini breaking down that right side. He makes a nice move, loses the ball, and Western's going to break away. Western's got the ball. They lose it there. Here comes York once again. Here's a good chance as the ball's played into the 18-yard box, but it bounces away.
York sustaining the pressure here, keeping it down in the Western end. You may have seen a change of momentum there with that one beautiful goal.
And here's Fabrizi looking for Lamy. Ball bouncing around outside the 18, dangerous spot again. Western's going to be clearing it away, but it's the Lions right back with it again. Ball cleared in on Murdoch. He'll have no trouble scooping that one up and playing it away.
A little miscommunication there.
So 8 minutes into the second half. Lions cutting that deficit into half. Now trailing 2-1. And they're back on the attack again. It's Lamy keeping the ball in, and it's another York goal. Antonini rating right on the 6. Lamy doing everything it took to keep the ball in bounds. And just like that, we're all tied up.
Lamy keeping that ball in, and Antonini with the finish. Ball comes right into him, making no mistake. This is a tie football game. Just with 53 minutes in, it's a long way to go still, but York stormed right back to begin the second half.
So a couple of goals only 8 minutes in. And Antonini making no mistake about it. A beautiful play by Lamy to keep that ball in bounds. It looked like it was right on the line, but the linesman's flag does not go up. Play stays alive, and perhaps the Mustangs defender is thinking that ball is out of bounds, leaving Antonini wide open in front of the goal. And just like that, we're all tied up.
Yeah, I did see a couple hands go up there thinking it was out, but regardless, it was an amazing play to keep it in and an amazing feed to the center of the net for a game-tying goal.
So just like that, the score is tied at 2. And that ball bounces out of bounds. Lions doing an excellent job of getting back into this game in the second half, taking a page out of that Western book, using the transition game and capitalizing on a couple of beautiful goals. We're tied at 2 now. as York tries to stay within striking distance of Western in the OUA West standings.
Mustangs getting the ball down to the York end for the first time this second half, really, but weren't able to generate much. York brings it back here.
Ball being pushed away by Orloff now to the left-hand side. The Lions are on the attack again, putting Western under and challenging the third-ranked team in the country. That's Bell with the ball. He'll try to push it forward, but once again, it's York cutting it off at midfield. Lions playing back to go forward. Can't get much going as the two teams trade possession inside the Western area. And here's Antonini pinching in again. Hungry for a second goal. And that one nearly cost them. Number 18, Orlov's going to be called for the foul here. Looked like he got a piece of the Western midfielder.
Yeah, desperation slide to kind of keep the pressure on there, but it got a little bit of backs there in the Western ball.
Perhaps Antonini being a little bit too aggressive there, tried to pinch up and ended up paying for it by his teammate getting the foul to keep from a great Western chance. Lions obviously in a situation with two early goals to complete the comeback with a third, but you don't want to get too aggressive here. You're already in position to earn the point. It'd be an absolute tragedy if you conceded 3 points at home after such a great comeback here in the second half. Lions playing with it in their own zone. Looking to push it forward now here. Another chance. York looking to push the ball forward. Playing with a lot more confidence after a couple of early goals here in the second half. Fabrizi doing an excellent job of getting the ball back to his goalkeeper, and York's going to have the chance to regroup here. 13 minutes into the second half here at York Stadium. It's the Mustangs. Lions tied at two after York scored two goals in the first 10 minutes of the half. I have the opportunity to leapfrog Western, and what an impact that would have if they were able to top the third-ranked team in the country here at their home stadium.
See York here taking their foot off the gas, you could say, as they play a more much more solid defensive game, just trying to limit the Western chances as they pick up their free kick here.
Ball played out to midfield and out of bounds. Suddenly, Western's on the defensive. Two-goal lead quickly evaporating here in the second half. And just like that, their undefeated streak is suddenly on the line. Here comes Fabrizi. Moving the ball over midfield and a great pass there. Lamy's going to get the shot. That one nowhere near the mark. That sails wide right. and out of bounds for a Western free kick. So as Murdoch gets set to take the kick, regroup here on SSN Canada. Dominic Padula and Alex Kuhn calling this one an exciting game here at York Stadium as the Lions come all the way back from two goals down. Now have the chance to end the streak of the only undefeated team in the OUA West. Smith plays the ball to Fabrizi. Fabrizi takes a look around. Nice ball into the middle of the 18-yard box, and it's going to bounce to Lamy. Lions fighting for the ball. They got possession. Shots blocked. Antonini's going to push up. And that ball's out of bounds for a corner kick.
Ball just bounced around in there and almost came back out onto the foot of the York Lions, and it's... That's what's been working for them lately, and they've been able to connect on two of them, tying this game up here in the second half, and they've got another chance to take the lead here with the corner.
Corner kick coming in. It was in the field of play when it was taken, but obviously the water having an effect of that one, the wind having an effect on that one as it sails over the net and off the back of the netting.
Both teams are going to need to make adjustments here as they switch ends. Different look for the keeper. Murdoch and York's got the wind at their back now, and it's something they'd really like to take advantage of this half.
Ball knocked out of bounds as we reach the 62nd minute mark. Lions and Mustangs tied at two here. Beautiful goal by the defender, Antonini. And suddenly what looked like it was going to be a blowout win for the top team in the OUA West has turned into what looks to be shaping up as quite an exciting finish for fans here at York Stadium. Ball played over to the right side. Fabrizi to Antonini and into Lamy. Beautiful flick on, but a little bit too much on it with this wind. That ball's going to sail right into Murdoch. We'll corral it for the kick. Big kick out past midfield. Nobody from Western up there. Four lines back to control that ball. You got to think about the coaching strategy at this point after conceding two goals. It seems as though Western's hanging back a little bit.
Yeah.
Maybe a little bit wary of protecting that undefeated streak.
Could be just about just getting this game back under control. Well, it seems the Lions are flying with all the momentum right now.
It seemed as though in the first half it was all Lions on the attack, with Western using the counterattack to take the early two-goal lead. We've seen that change a little bit in the second half, with York getting back on the board with a couple of transition goals. It wouldn't be a surprise to see Western sit back and try to protect that undefeated streak here the rest of the way. They're on the attack right now, and it's Mavrikos pushing the ball over to number 9. That's Baxa. He switches the field of play, but once again, as we've seen earlier, only 3 Western attackers compared to 6 back for the York Lions. Here come the Lions in transition. Playing the ball to the top of the 18. Knocked loose and away. and out of bounds. Ball kicked out to midfield. Smith controls it for the Lions. Playing it back in. Here's a great opportunity for the Lions. Chance to take the lead, and they've done it. The York Lions have come all the way back from down two goals, and its leading scorer, Adrian Penna, with a left-footed strike top shelf, York is suddenly in front.
Make that Alan Vedat that made it, scored that goal, beating the defender and making no mistake. Murdoch's almost in disbelief back in his net, allowing three goals, almost unheard of for a goaltender that has 11 shutouts this year.
And what a job by the Lions, down 2-0 at the half. They've needed only 21 minutes to score three straight goals and take the lead. And suddenly the undefeated Western Mustangs are on the verge of having their streak ended. And another shot off the bar. The Lions all over them here. And the linesman's flag is up for the offside call, but another shot high off the bar. Wow, what an effort by the Lions here.
You can see that ball just carried a little bit further. Wind at your back has that advantage, but really the wind hasn't been the difference this half. This has been all York.
Lions doing a great job here. Mavrikos getting a little bit upset, and it looked like there's a couple of punches thrown by Mavrikos. That's going to be a red card guaranteed, and Lammy's getting it into him with him. Lammy holding him down, and there's about five or six York Lions holding Mavrikos back. Things are getting a little bit intense here as the Lions defender's down on the field holding his head. Absolutely unacceptable from Mavrikos, throwing a couple of punches and then what looked like a kick, and everybody's out there on the field now as the referees try to get hold of this game.
If you're Mavrikos, you got to be a lot smarter than this. Your team's down by one goal. You haven't had the best start to the half, but come on, you're the second leading goal scorer in the league. Your team needs you. You can't go around doing this. It's just not good for your team, not good for yourself.
And they're calling the trainers onto the field now, as that's number 11, Mastorovic. It appears to be down. Looked like he took both a punch and a boot to the face. Absolutely unacceptable from Mavrikos. And you have to wonder about the state of this Mustangs team and what the head coach is going to have to do here as Rock Bisacco watches on from the sidelines as his star striker is about to be sent off the field with what should undoubtedly be an automatic red card. So Mavrikos having words with the linesman here now. Referee's going to show him a red card. That was something that everybody knew was going to happen. Absolutely unacceptable. Yellow card's going to go to Murdoch, the goaltender. Things starting to unravel here for the Mustangs at York Stadium. Absolutely unfortunate. Coach Bisacco is going to have a word. I'm surprised as Lammy's now going to be sent off the field with a red card. That's absolutely unacceptable.
Lammy causing quite the scene
as he
leaves.
You have to wonder why Lammy's being sent off the field. I didn't see him do anything more than restrain Mavrikos. This is definitely an unfortunate circumstance for the Lions. A great job by Lammy a key integral part in getting this team back into this game, and now he's going to leave for doing nothing more than restraining an irate Mavrikos.
I think it could have been just a matter of he was in there right away and the ref saw him come in and I saw him wrap his arm right around the neck. I don't know if the ref would have seen that as restraining or
but it
as...
It wasn't Laflamme that... Or it wasn't... It wasn't Lamy who was with his arms around Mavrikos from behind. Lamy was the one who came in late and sort of put his hands in front of his shoulders to stop him from throwing punches. Didn't appear as though he threw any punches himself. And you have to wonder why a red card was warranted under those circumstances.
Well, you know one thing, that this game is just finally starting to live up to its billing. 2-0 early. There wasn't really much going on aside from those two goals, but the high-powered York offense, they've come back 3 straight goals, and now tempers are starting to flare as both teams are not pleased with each other. A lot of passion being shown out on this field.
So some substitutions made, and there is Mustarovic on the sidelines looking to get back in the game. Not sure if that initial punch connected, but without a doubt he did take another kick and a punch to the face. He seems to be okay as he makes his way back onto the field. An unfortunate situation, something you never want to see in college athletics.
But it just goes to show that how much these athletes are putting into this game. They know the importance of it. 2 best teams in the league. First overall in the league up for grabs tonight, or up this afternoon. Absolutely fantastic effort shown in the second half by York Lions, and the Mustangs were not pleased at all with it.
Smith controlling the ball, dishes it off, receives it back. A lot more space available here with a couple of players sent off. Lions could have had the chance with the advantage. It appeared to be a situation where York would be up one man after the referees decided to take Lamy off the field with a red card, suddenly down to 10 men aside. So an exciting finish here in this highly anticipated battle for first place, as the undefeated Mustangs have watched their 2-goal lead at halftime disappear. And now here in the second half, watching their star striker exit the field after absolutely losing his composure and attacking a Lions defender. You want to give the benefit of the doubt to the player in that circumstance, but Rico's not the type of player to engage in that sort of activities. It's hard from up here to understand the situation down on the field, if there was anything more that played into it. But at the end of the day, it comes down to keeping your composure, and that's something that almost ultimately would have cost this team. So Lions with the ball, it's Mavrikos with it. And he'll play the ball over to Smith. Smith with the ball. Passing it over to Antonini. They're looking to push that ball forward. Western with the ball back. Looking a little bit more organized offensively, but there's an offside call there on Western number 2, John Morrissey, I believe. And we reach the 74th minute mark of the second half. Only 30 minutes played in the second half, but tons of action with 3 goals, couple of red cards. Packed house here at York Stadium, and they're getting quite the show. Lions moving the ball around on midfield. A couple of key pieces for both teams in Mavrikos and Lamy already sent off. Western perhaps fortunate to be even strength in this game, as you see Murdoch chest the ball down and allow it to creep into his penalty area, where he plays it off to the defender. Western Mustangs bus sits just outside of the stadium, and you know their players would like to go on it with their undefeated streak still intact. The Lions are going to make a substitution here as number six, Alberti, leaves the field. Taking his place on that attacking spot will be number eight, Francesco Vecchio. So the midfielder from Woodbridge, Ontario, is on the field now, providing some fresh legs for the Lions. They're going to need them as they're now down to 10 men. And the space on this field, everything will surely open up. Ball bouncing around at midfield. Lions trying to get something going. There's going to be another foul on the play and another booking. As the referee goes into his pocket, he's got number 10, Rochek, the other Mustangs forward. And we'll see what he'll be called for here after the rough tackle. Referee understanding the situation after a couple of red cards and trying to make sure this game doesn't get out of hand again. A yellow card will be given to Rochek. Lions have the ball. Nice little turnaround there. Moving it forward. Lions with a little bit of an unfortunate situation coming all the way back, but then having that red card to Lamy looks to have maybe spoiled their momentum a little bit. And as we approach the 78-minute mark of the second half, it's Lions 3, Western 2. Ball played into the box. Good chance there by York, but unable to come up with anything, and Murdoch's going to make the stop. We're in the 78th minute mark here at York Stadium. Alex Kuhn and Dominic Padula calling this game for SSNCanada.ca live from York Stadium. And suddenly, a game that it seemed Western had in the books, that's no longer the case now. The Lions leading 3-2. Lions with the throw-in. And you have to wonder, Alex, you think about it. All five goals scored in this game were on that same net that the Lions just put their third one into.
And even all three in the women's game as well.
And you have to wonder how much of a factor the wind has played in that.
No, you can, just sitting up in the booth here, you can hear the wind howling. And you can see the jerseys flapping out there. You can see a Canadian flag, and even on the in the corners here, you can just tell that the wind is blowing out there.
That may not be the only thing flopping. Has a tough play there. offside called, eliminating a great Lions chance.
A very good chance as the Lions continue to press here, and it's really been just one-sided this entire second half.
Mustangs are going to have to pick up their play to keep their undefeated streak alive, and they got the ball here in the York area. 80th minute, 3-2 the score. Both teams reduced to 10 men after an unfortunate situation. And a foul called against Western there. That's not going to help them.
We keep talking about streaks and how Western's got this undefeated streak going with their 10-0-2 record. But this is going to be, if it continues to be like this, it'll be York's seventh straight victory, which is absolutely amazing. And they'll be able to finish off at home as well. They welcome Guelph here next Saturday, and they play Windsor on Sunday.
So the chance for the Lions to move into first place in the OUA standings.
And then the teams they face, Guelph and Windsor, each only have 2 wins on the season, so it's...
So if the Lions could hold on and beat a team of Western's caliber, you can imagine the thoughts of the Lions players going forward with the chance to lock up first place in the OUA West. Western breaking down the right side. Chance to send the ball in. That's going to be stopped easily by Varlikostas. Varlikostas hasn't seen many touches here in the second half. Lions doing a great job of protecting their goalie.
Yeah, the field has definitely shifted to a more defensive game as York now just looks for possession, keeping the ball and keeping the time ticking off that clock, because they're in a great position right now after a fantastic start to the second half.
Mustangs with a throw. Trying to get something going here. It's the first time this season that Western's really faced this kind of pressure trailing this late in the game against a team of the Lions caliber. A real test of character. Lions fighting for the ball at midfield. 3-2 the score for York. 83rd minute. Lions with 3 second half goals to take the lead. Ball played down the left flank. Mustangs trying to get something going. Lions keeping everything to the outside. There's a lovely through ball there. Mustangs with a chance. Ball centered in. What a save that was by Varlikostas. Absolutely saves the day by the Lions with an incredible stop. That was a point blank redirect. And Varlikostas manages to get just enough to let it bounce off the post and out. What a save by the Lions goaltender.
Absolutely fantastic. First time he's really been tested this second half, and he came up huge for York.
So it's Varlikostas with a tremendous save to keep the Lions in the lead as we reach the 84-minute mark in this contest. The crowd coming alive as our goalkeeper getting his team pumped up with a game-changing save. Yeah. Ball bounces over midfield. Mustangs trying desperately to get something going. Clock not on their side in this one as they trail at the 85-minute mark. One goal deficit, certainly not insurmountable, but with the way this half's gone, certainly quite a tough task.
Almost had a chance there, but the offside was called. The flag went up late. Definitely not pleased were most of the Mustang players.
There's little you can do from the sidelines for head coach Rock Bisacco. He felt he had done everything that he could to get his team to this point. And with a 2-0 lead at the half, quite a tough situation as that ball bounces around inside the Lions' 18-yard box, but really not much of a threat. So Lions do an excellent job of clearing it. That ball rolls back out of bounds once again. We talk about Coach Bisacco watching from the sidelines. Really nothing you can do.
No.
He's put his players in a position to succeed. Now it's up to Western to try to even the score here late. Mustangs on the attack again. Just outside the 18-yard box. For the Lions, everybody back except Penna. Throw in for Antonini. Knocked away. Bounces over to the defenders. And the pull there. And that ball's knocked away. Free kick award to the Lions.
And they'll take their time with it. Or not.
No rush really for the York there, but... You know, deciding to move the ball quickly, turns out that pace helped them as Antonini draws another foul. Maybe they'll slow down here as that time clock continues to tick. And the York Lions, what a day after their women knocked off the Western women to move into fifth spot in the OUA West. The men with a chance to climb into first place. Ball knocked out of bounds. Linesman's got his flag up. It looks as though Murdoch is going to have to retake the goal kick. The ball wasn't on the line. You got to wonder why you would cheat in that sort of situation, especially when you're just playing a simple pass up towards midfield.
And where there's only a minute and just over a minute left in the game.
Clearly, it's a matter of composure. As Mustangs and a foul called there. The ball's going to be going back to the Mustangs. So 89th minute. Everything's on the line here. Western desperately trying to get back into this one. And Hassan moves the ball forward. And that ball is played out of bounds once again. Lions content just to throw the ball down that left side. And the referee will take a look at his watch. We're now in injury time. Lions on the verge of pulling off a major comeback upset. Western undefeated heading into this game as they run out one final opportunity. Mustangs desperate to keep their winning streak alive. Ball pushed into Mrochik. He dishes it back. Everybody up for Western except Murdoch. Trying to get into the 18-yard box. Everybody back for the Lions. Ball played into the 18-yard box. Bell with a flick on. Here's a chance for Western. Ball bouncing loose. And it's, of course, who else? But Varla Costas coming up with a grab. No rush to get up.
Varla Costas hangs on to that ball, and he kicks that one way out of his end. That was much closer than the York Lions definitely wanted.
Long ball played forward. York trying to control it, hoping that ball will stay in bounds, and it will, as it bounces over midfield once again. Lions trying to maintain possession. That's the substitution right there, Vesio. Vesio playing the little give and go. Lions back on the ball again with another substitution, Oliviero. Those two content just to let time pass. Referee has another look at his watch, and the time continues to tick down as York clears the ball once again. The looks on some of the Western players tells the story. Two-goal lead erased. And they'll retake the throw. And perhaps enough time for one more chance. Is there enough time?
Excellent control by the defensive line there. Not letting anything through. They've been playing lockdown almost all second half, and it's been a completely one-sided half.
Take a look at the Lions bench. All eyes are on the referee now, waiting for that final whistle. Mustangs hoping there's at least enough time for one more chance. They'll get a free kick here. Ball played into the middle. Bouncing around inside the box. York has to get the ball out of the danger area. It continues to bounce around inside. Here's another opportunity. Varla Costas with the first save. They have to get the ball out. Mustangs all over it, and eventually it's cleared. Murdoch meets it at center.
Varla Costas is coming up huge for the York Lions, keeping this game alive, keeping with the lead.
And there's the final whistle. The York Lions and their fans will celebrate as live from York Stadium, the Lions complete what seemed like an insurmountable comeback and end Western's streak with a 3-2 win here at York Stadium. For Alex Kuhn, I'm Dominic Padula. Special thank you to Dylan Kalman working the camera for us. For SSNCanada.ca, we're going to sign out here. It's York 3, Western 2. The Mustangs' undefeated streak comes to an end.
over the through the central areas, scored a great goal as well. So, I mean, it's a lot about ability, character, and passion, which is something that we needed.
Do you think this team is ready for the playoffs?
I mean, playoffs, as we know, we won a division handily last year, and we came here and we lost 1-0 at home to the same Western team. Mentally, physically, we're there. You know, we're ready, we're tuned in. We just got to fine-tune a few pieces and make sure we do the simple things well, like properly in the first half, understanding the difference between a defensive header and a regular header, not to give that opportunity up. Those are the things that we need to do, is concentrate on doing the simple things well.
All right, congratulations, Coach. That's Lions head coach Carmen Izako after his team's 3-2 win over Western.
Costas, you made two huge saves. Just talk about how big those were.
Well, at the end of the game, it proved to be really big because we won by one goal. But it's all my credit to the defense, the midfield, and the forwards. They all defended as a team. The two times at the end of the game where they did break through them, I was just able to get my face in front of one and my hands on the other.
All right, now this was a huge game. Talk about how big of a win this was for your team.
Well, we lost to Western at the beginning of the season, and throughout the entire season, we've been trying to chase them to catch up to first place. And this was the game to, if we win, we come in first. That's basically the end of the day.
All right, now, do you feel this team has what it takes to do a successful playoff run?
I think Nationals are a disappointment.
All right, well, that was the goaltender, Varla Costas, as they take down the Western Mustangs.